Welcome back to the channel. In today's session, we are going to learn how we can create the approval flow along with the reminders. So if some person is not taking any action on his or her task, then that person should be receiving the periodic reminders to take the action on the task. So as of now, we in Flow, in Power Automate, we have that feature of adding the approval flows, but there is no configurations to send out the reminders. So there is no by default or out of the box way where you can just set up the configuration and should start sending the reminders. For that, you have to add few functions, a few actions, so that it can take care of that periodic thing. So whether the task is completed, and if it's completed, then it should stop sending reminders. Otherwise, it should keep on based on your requirement periodic interval. So it could be 1 day, 1 week, or based on due date as well. So to explain the concept, I have created one approval tracking list, and it's a pretty standard list with title, approvers, and status column. And this approver field is a multi-selection approver field. So that means you can add up the multiple approvers to it. So now let's start building the flow based on it. So I'm just creating automated from blank, and the trigger I'm using when an item is created, and the name is approval flow with demo reminders. And in this flow, I'll just choose my that approver tracking list as in trigger point. And in next step, I'll be initializing one variable where I can set up or read out all the approvers to this task. So I can just initializing one variable that is approvers, and it's a string type. In next step, I'll use append to string action. And why I'm going to use that, because I'll be appending all the approvers, because as I said, it will be multiple selection approver field, and I have to append all the approvers in single string that should be semicolon separated. So when I say append to string variable, I'm choosing this approver variable, and under this value, I'm using approver email. And when I click on approver email, it will add up by default this action under the apply to each, because that's a multi-selection field. So now we have added approvers, but I'll need to add the semicolon because I want them as a semicolon separated string. So that's why I've added that up. And in next step, I'll choose start and wait for approval. And in this, what this action would do, it will create one task for that specific approvers list. And you can define what approval type you're looking for. So if you want everyone must to approve before that item gets to a status of completed, then you would be choosing everyone must approve. And if you want like anybody can approve, then you can choose first to respond. Anyone who responded first would be taken as an outcome. So I'm choosing everyone must approve. And I'll be configuring this task. I'll just say title in another title field. And before that, I can type please take action on title key, item title, and in assign to, I'll add up the dynamic content as approvers, which we set up in the previous step. And under the item link, I can just link that to link to item, and under link item link description, you can simply say title. Alright, so right now, till this step, we have created the task for all the approvers which are there in our list. So now how to set up that with the reminders? For that, I'll be adding one action in between this apply to each and start approval as an initialize variable. And that variable I'm going to use to make a decision whether we should keep sending reminders or not. So I'm using that as initialize variable stop reminders. And let it be boolean. Let's set up that value as false initial value. All right, so initial value false, that means like you should send out the reminders. Now as a next step, I'll add up that as a parallel branch. So what it does is it created that task in one branch and will look for the reminders logic into the separate different branch. So for reminders, you may want to send a reminder based on some periodic thing. So you can just use delay action, and in delay action, you can specify what unit you want to delay it. So minute, day, or week. So you can specify that. So I'm just saying 1 minute for testing because I can't keep waiting for one day for this demo. So I can just saving it, setting that up as 1 minute. And after that, I'll use one loop which will check whether my task has been actioned or not. And if not, then it should keep on sending the reminder. So the action we are going to use do until. Where is that action? So we have this. Now we'll set up the exit condition for this loop, and which is stop reminders. And right now it's grayed out, so you just click on advanced mode and click back on advanced basic mode, then it get enabled. You can set up the value. So when stop reminders get set up to true value, then it should exit. Otherwise it will add another delay, and possibly based on your requirement you want to send that reminder after 1 day each every day, then you would set up that as 1 day, but for testing I'll be choosing that as 1 minute. All right, so now we have set up this initial delay, then in under do until we set up the exit condition, and we have set up another delay for 1 minute for the next reminders. And come back to the left branch, I'll be setting up this variable for the exit condition. So set variable I'm going to use, and I'll say set task stop reminder variable as true, so that it can be passed on this condition, and based on this true value it can exit from this do until. And as a next step, as a final step, we'll be setting the status column for this item. So what action been taken by the approvers. I'll just set up the connection as my same list. Under the ID, I'll just pass on the ID of this item. Under title, I will pass the title of the when an item is created. Under status, the outcome of this task should be set under the status. So I'll use outcome, and which is of start and wait for an approval, will be finally set as an status of this item. So we are done. So we have created, we read out all the approvers, we created one task, we set up the reminder logic, we set up the do until condition for exit and delay. But where is the email, reminder email? So we forgot that. I will just add that email as send email. And we'll just move this action to above to this delay. Now we'll just set up whom we want to send the reminder email to approvers, and what should be the subject. It subject will be gentle reminder, please take action. And you can just append the title of the field, and under the body you can simply say please take action on. Again, title you can specify, not this one, you can specify title from this when an item is created. So now we have set up the reminder email as well, and you can also put the direct link to the approval task. So I'm not doing that right now, I'm just saving this so that I can demo that to you. Now I can go back to my list and create one item. So let's say test approval item 1, and I'm just setting the approver. So right now in this environment I don't have any other approver, any other user, so I'm just using my name. And definitely it's going to work with the multiple user selection as well, because we have written the logic in that fashion. Now I'm saving it, and it has saved, and we'll just go back to our flow to see whether it ran or not. Okay, so it's running, I'm clicking on that. Can see it's giving that yellow sign. That means it's waiting for this task and it's waiting for this delay. So task must have created by this time, and I should have got one email as well. So you can see I got that email, approval item 1, take action. And on the parallel branch is waiting for that periodic time to get complete. So we set that up as 1 minute, so it will be waiting for 1 minute to send out the first reminder. So I'm just pausing it for a moment so that I can get first reminder. Alright, so the delay is completed and I should get the first reminder. So I got this reminder, please take action on this gentle reminder. And now it's keep on waiting for my do until logic, and which is checking whether approval is completed or not. So it will keep on waiting for one more email, and meantime let me just approve that so that I should not get the second reminder email. And if you see, I've just approved it. On the left hand side, it set up that variable, it updated the item. If I go back to my item, then the action outcome is being saved there in the status. And it is kept on running. And why is still running? Because it's waiting for that 1 minute duration under do until, and after that it will see whether that stop reminder variable is being set true or not. And once that is done, so it will just automatically get out of that loop. So now you just saw that it ran successfully and it closed, it exited that group because this variable got set true value. So that's how we created one approval flow and with custom reminder functionality. So based on your periodic time, whatever time you want to set, you can also have one due date. Based on that, you can do the calculations that what time period your reminder flow should wait to send out the reminders. So I believe this would be very beneficial for you if you want to set up the approval flow with reminders. So if you like my video, please do subscribe and just drop a thumbs up. Thank you.